Hey guys, today I want to show you how to create a very simple grid pattern swatch like this in Adobe Illustrator. So the first thing we want to do is draw the illustrations we want for our pattern. I'm going for these simple illustrations, but these could be any kind of illustrations that you want for your pattern. If your illustrations consist of multiple shapes, you have to group each illustration first. When you are done drawing your illustrations, we have to make some adjustments to the size of the illustrations. To create the nice straight lines in your pattern, we want the width of each illustration to be exactly the same. So choose one of your illustrations, go to Transform, and change the width of your illustration to whatever size you want. Remember to keep the link enabled to keep the proportions of the illustrations. For this project, I will choose 100 pixels. Do this for each one of your illustrations. When all your illustrations have exactly the same width, we want to align them on a straight horizontal line. So now select all your illustrations, go to Window and check your Align panel right here. Then go down to the Align panel and click Vertical Align Center. When all your illustrations are aligned, we want to go down to Distribute Spacing. If you don't have this option, go to this panel right here and click Show Options. Now select Align To and Align To Key Object. Now go to this window right here and find out how much spacing you want between your illustrations. For this project, I will choose 100 pixels, but this could be anything. So type in your spacing and click on Horizontal Distribute Space. If you want to change the spacing, you can just type in another number and click this button again. When you are happy with your spacing, keep the illustration selected and go to Object, go to Pattern and go to Make. From here, we have to do some adjustments. So now go to Size Tile to Art. And because we know the exact spacing between each illustration, we can now enable this link and type in the exact spacing that you used between your objects. For me, it's 100 pixels. For you, it will be whatever you typed in right here. But to make the pattern more interesting, we want to shift the pattern so it's not the same illustration all the way down. So now go to Tile Type and select Brick by Row. And down here, you can select the brick offset. I'm choosing a half brick offset. The brick is this rectangle right here. So a half brick offset means that if you go half a brick in, the pattern will be repeated right here. If you have an odd number of illustrations, like 3 for example, you will have to choose 1/3 right here. But if you choose a third and you have an even number, it will arrange it to kind of a zigzag pattern right here. So let's choose a half. When you are happy, click Done. Now the pattern swatch is saved right here. So you can delete your shapes and draw any kind of shape. And while having the fill selected, click on your pattern. If you ever want to change your pattern, you can always double-click the pattern. And from here you can recolor your illustrations, or you can resize them to make the pattern even more interesting to look at. So let's try to do that. So select the selection tool, and select the shape you want to resize. So the best way to resize it is to hold down the Alt key to resize it from the center, and also hold down the Shift key to keep the proportions. Now resize your illustration. You can do the same for the other illustrations. As you can see, you can be very creative right here. I will keep my original pattern, so I will click Cancel. Now, if you have drawn a shape and you want to resize it, the pattern will get stretched as this. To fix it, you just click one more time at the pattern swatch. And if you made a specific shape that you want to keep, but you want the pattern inside the shape to be larger, you can right-click the shape, go to Transform, and go to Scale. From here, uncheck Transform Objects, and now you can resize it up here. If you want a background color for your pattern, you simply put the background color behind the pattern. So select the pattern, go to Edit, go to Copy, go to Edit once again, and go to Paste in Back. Now select the color you want for your background. If you want to learn to draw a heart like this, click on the video on the end screen right now.